If you have ever went rock climbing, played guitar, lifted weights, or spent a long time working with your hands, you are probably familiar with the hard skin that sometimes forms on your palms, known as calluses. Even if you haven't done any of these things, years of walking will have given you a callus or two on the soles of your feet. But what actually are these things we call calluses, and how do they end up on our skin? Your skin is your body's largest organ. An organ is just a collection of tissue in the body that is adapted to perform a specific function. So yes, just like your heart, liver, and lungs, your skin is also an organ. Your skin is made up of two main layers. First, we have the dermis, which is the sturdy foundational layer of our skin, and on top of that, we have the epidermis. The epidermis is your body's first line of defense whenever we expose our skin to the different things our environments throw at us. The epidermis contains a number of different cells, but the ones that make up the majority of the epidermis are known as keratinocytes. The epidermis can be further broken down into five different layers, and the keratinocytes begin their journey at the very bottom, the stratum basale. In this bottom layer, we have the baby keratinocytes. As they move up through the layers, they begin to change in a process known as differentiation. Differentiation is the process where a cell can change into a completely different type of cell. The keratinocytes complete their differentiation when they reach the top layer of the epidermis, the stratum corneum. In the stratum corneum, the keratinocytes undergo apoptosis, which is programmed cell death. The keratinocytes that died taking one for the team are now known as corneocytes. These corneocytes are mainly made up of keratin, which is the fibrous protein that we also find in our hair and nails. In the corneocytes, the keratin molecules bundle together to form filaments, which are organized in bundles to create a tough layer of protective outer skin. When we expose our hands or feet to repetitive friction through activities like walking or weightlifting, our skin undergoes a process called hyperkeratosis. This is where there is a greater amount of keratin in the corneocytes, resulting in the top layer of our epidermis, the stratum corneum, becoming thicker. This thickening of the stratum corneum is what is happening when calluses form, and it happens to give some extra protection to the areas of skin we are putting under a lot of mechanical stress. So next time you see a callus appear on your skin, you can take a moment to appreciate the little keratinocytes that gave their lives to keep your skin happy and healthy. Thanks for watching. If you enjoyed the video, please leave a like and consider subscribing for a new video every Saturday about the science of everyday life.